Here's a helpful video if you're struggling on today's assignment for graphing lines. One thing you want to recognize is your equation y equals 3x minus 1 is in the form of y equals mx plus b, where m is your slope, the number in front of x, b is your y-intercept, the value by itself, the constant. So that is your starting point here. So you need to take a point here and drag it to negative 1. Our slope is positive 3, so you want to recognize, since your slope's a whole number, you always want to put your whole numbers over 1 to identify your rise over your run. Your rise is your numerator. Your run is the denominator. So because it's a positive 3, we're going up 3. Because it's a positive 1, you're moving to the right 1. So here, you're going to begin at negative 1 on the y-axis because that's your y-intercept, b. So if you take your point, drag it, and place it at negative 1, that's your starting point. You're going to take another point, and you're going to place it using the slope to move. We're going to move from my starting point up 1, 2, 3, right 1, and put a point. Up 1, 2, 3, and right 1, put your point. Again, from that point, you're going to go up 1, 2, 3, and put a point. That's your slope. Up 3, right 1. You can go down, or you can continue up your graph, but if I want to plot points to the left of negative 1, your y-intercept, you're going to go down 1, 2, 3, left 1. And now you're going to grab this orange line, and you're going to put it on these points to connect it. So if I want to move this line, I'm going to use the symbol at the top to move it. Now I can connect them, and there's my line. Starts at negative 1, and the slope is up 1, 2, 3, right 1, up 1, 2, 3, right 1. If you need to move that line so that it is a little straighter, you can. But that's all you're doing for your equation. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and move on to the next one. I'm going to do a few examples for you so that you understand how to do this. You can always go back and pause the video if you don't understand or you need to see it again. Now we're going to look at an example with a negative slope. So slide number 7. So this is in the form of y equals mx plus b, where m is the value in front of x, your slope, negative 4/3, and b is the value by itself, positive 6. So this is telling me I'm going to start at positive 6 on the y-axis, and then because my slope is negative 4/3, I'm going to use my rise over run. When my rise is negative, it means I'm going to go down. My run is always to the right. So let's go ahead and plot the points. We are starting at positive 6 on the y. So you go to positive 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and plot your point. And then we're going to move down for right 3 to plot some more points. So from that starting point, we're going to move down 1, 2, 3, 4, right 1, 2, 3, and plot your point. Again, from here, we're going to move down 1, 2, 3, 4, right 1, 2, 3, and plot your point. We can't go any further, so we're going to just go ahead and take this line and connect our points here. And that's how you would graph that line. It has a negative slope, and it's going down. It starts at positive 6, down 4, right 3, down 4, right 3. Okay, if you need more time, pause the video. I'm going to move on to the next slide. On the next slide, I'm going to go over number 9. It is in the form y equals mx plus b. So the only thing we need to do is identify what the y-intercept is. Y equals mx plus b. So in this example, my values in front of y is a negative 1. So I want to understand that the slope's a negative 1. I don't see anything added or subtracted. to this equation. So I need to understand that that means it's a plus zero. So B is a y-intercept at zero. Well, that means it's at the origin. So if my slope is negative one, I always want to take my slope and write it as a fraction. Well, any whole number can be written over one. And so what this recognizes is that the negative one is my rise, which is going down. I'm going down one, right one, but I'm starting at the origin. So if I go ahead and get my points, I'm going to start at zero on the y, and then I'm going to use my slope to move to plot more points. So I'm going to go from the origin, down one, right one, down one, right one. And if I wanted to plot points in the opposite direction, I would start at the origin and go up one, left one, up one, left one. So I'm going to go ahead and use my cursor to move that. And now I can grab my line and connect those points. Okay, pause the video if you need more time. The last question I'm going to go over is the next slide, where the order is just written differently. So you want to recognize that. On slide number 11, slide number 10. It is in the form y equals mx plus b, but they just have it in a different order. So you want to recognize m, the slope, is the value in front of x with that sign. So here my slope is a negative 5 over 4. That means I'm going down 5 and right 4. My b is a positive 5 on the y-intercept. So I would be starting at positive 5. And then I will move down 5, right 4. Down 5, right 4. If you can't plot more than 2 points, then that's fine. I hope this video was helpful. Go ahead and submit your assignment and take a look at those Quizlet videos or slides so that you can be prepared for your test on Tuesday.